France is not stopping at radical imams. It has taken a series of retaliatory measures against Pakistan. This includes Pakistan's military establishment. Our next report tells you more.
If Pakistan thought it could get away with this blunder, it was wrong. Imran Khan is paying a hefty price for this tweet. It had claimed that Macron is treating Muslims like Nazis had treated Jews. Mazari deleted her tweet, but the damage was done. The anger in France was boiling over. To blame everything on a tweet would be unfair, because Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan was the one who decided to pick a fight with France. But Mazari's statement only made the situation worse. Paris is now hitting back at Islamabad.
D'où qu'ils viennent.
France will not upgrade Pakistan's fleet of Mirage fighter jets, an air defense system, and the Agusta 90B class submarines. Reportedly, France has sent a message to Qatar too, asking them to not allow Pakistani origin technicians to work on the Rafale jets. If that wasn't enough, France will now put asylum requests from Pakistan under detailed scrutiny. Pakistan's decision to take on France seems to have come with a hefty price tag. It all began when Imran Khan sided with Turkey's Recep Tayyip Erdogan and accused the French president of attacking Islam. Erdogan, alongside Imran Khan and Mahathir Mohamad, added fuel to the fire against France. Their statements added to the outrage against France in the Muslim world, leading to violent rallies across major Islamic countries. There were protests in Pakistan too, where protesters burnt effigies of Macron and desecrated the French flag. Extremists and radicals took to the streets with large crowds. They tried to target the French embassy in Islamabad. More recently, Islamabad was held hostage by Islamists. Led by the far-right Islamic political party, the Tehrik-e-Labaik, its supporters forced the Imran Khan government to make concessions. Pakistani ministers signed an agreement promising to evict the French ambassador to Pakistan and a boycott of French goods at the government level. The Pakistan Prime Minister has lost control of his own anti-France campaign, with Islamists dictating the terms of engagement with France at home and France responding with diplomatic actions. Imran Khan now finds himself caught between a rock and a hard place. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.